My name is Anne-Marie. Welcome to my channel and welcome to lesson 9 of how to play the saxophone for complete beginners. Warm up time. This is what the note A or La looks like on a stave. This is the high A. You already know how to play the low A, and the difference between the low one and the high one is that for the high one, you simply use an octave key. So as a warm-up, what I'd like you to do is practice moving from your low A, then adding your octave key, going up to your high A and coming back down. You may need to adjust your embouchure by tightening your mouth muscles around the mouthpiece a little more to get the higher note. Now do the same with the notes G, F sharp, E and D. This is what the exercises sound like on an alto sax. Press pause and practice. Improving your sound. And the way you're going to practice doing this is by blowing long notes. But not just blowing the long notes long, you're going to start off by blowing as quietly or softly as possible, gradually getting louder, and then you gradually get softer again and stop. Notice that wobble at the end of the note. That's called vibrato. We'll be talking about vibrato in later lessons, but it does give a really nice sound. I want you to practice with all the notes that you know until you sound a little more like me. Press pause and practice. How to play the note low C. Now, low notes on the saxophone are notoriously hard to get. So why am I playing the clarinet? Well, the shape of the clarinet makes the low notes on a clarinet quite easy to get. So if you're a clarinet player moving on to saxophone, you might find sounding the low notes on a saxophone a bit harder. This is a low C on a tenor and on an alto. And this is how you play it. So to play the low C, you have all of your fingers on as if you're playing a low D, and you use your little finger to hit this key. Not this one, that's a different note, but this key here. Make sure you get the right one. So that's the D, and you put this on, and that gives you your low C. Now practice playing it a few times, or quite a lot. And it might take the wind out of you, literally. Press pause and practice. Now, once you can play your low C note, you may realise that you can now play a new scale, which is the C major scale. Now, notice there's no F sharp, it's an F. And obviously there's no C sharp, it's a C. Now, if you're familiar with the film The Sound of Music and you know the Do Re Mi song, the solfa as written will be very recognisable. Only here the note B is called C, and in some countries it's called T. I'm not going to play it for you. You should now be able to recognise the sound of a major scale. So what I want you to do, I want you to play the C major scale starting from your low C going up to your middle C as shown on the score. And then I want you to go down again. When you go from the low C up to the middle C, that's called ascending, going up. And then when you go back down from the middle C down to your low C, that's called descending. Press pause and practice. How to play the song Happy Birthday to You. Now, this is a song that everybody should have in their repertoire. And this may well be the first song you play in public. Anyway, I've got a few things I need to go through with you, so let's get started. First thing is that this song is in the key of C major, or uses the C major scale. So there are no sharps, no F sharp, no C sharp. It's an F natural and a C natural. The song has three beats in every bar. So instead of having a pulse of 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, which is four beats in a bar, this has three beats like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, and so forth, okay? Despite that, whenever you sing happy birthday in public, most people will count 1, 2, 3 and then expect everyone to start on the fourth beat. But now you know best, don't you? Now, you may be wondering, well, the first bar, the notes add up to one beat. So how comes it's three beats in a bar? Well, if you look at the last bar, the notes add up to two. So if you add that two to the one beat in the first bar, you get three. And music's sometimes written like that, so that if you're going to repeat it, you just go straight back to the beginning on the right bar, on the right note, on the right beat of the bar. Another thing you need to look at. Now, in bar seven, in the seventh bar, you can see a kind of a crescent with a dot underneath it. That's called a pause mark. And what that tells you is that you just pause there for maybe 1 second or so. If you know the song Happy Birthday to You, it's the part where you say the person's name. Happy birthday to you. And there's a natural pause, and then you carry on. Happy birthday to you. And finally, remember when you did your octave practice from your low G to your high G? Well, this is where it comes in handy, moving from this G to this G. Now it's your turn to learn the song. Pause the video, use the sheet music, and read from there. But if you find that challenging, here's me playing it on the alto and the tenor. And here's something handy as well. All the D's are with an octave key. And if you want to tell the difference between the low G and the high G, the G that has a comma next to it is the high G. Press pause and practice. How to play Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Now here's the sheet music for Somewhere Over the Rainbow. The song's actually called Over the Rainbow, but a lot of people just call it Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Anyway, I'm not actually going to say too much about this because what I want you to do, I want you to work out how to do this yourself. And the reason I want you to do that is because I really want you to make this song your own. Everything you've learnt so far, you can put into this song. There's octave jumps, for example. You've been doing a lot of breathing practice, so you've got long notes. And this song in particular, it's really important that the tone of your saxophone, the tone of your saxophone, or the sound that you make is really good. And it's a good, really good song to practice getting your tone really well, because it's not fast. So you can't hide behind any fast run of notes or anything. It's a ballad, and it's a dreamy ballad about wishing to be somewhere else. So the way you sound is really, really important in this song. The other thing I want you to think about is where you're going to breathe. Now, you're going to hear me play it twice, once on alto and once on tenor. And you may notice that I breathe in different places. And you may want to experiment where you want to catch your quick breath and breathe, because it's almost like a sentence. So, for example, there's a line in the song that goes, "Birds fly over the rainbow, why then oh why can't I?" Now, you could say that in different ways, like this. Example one, "Birds fly over the rainbow," and you'd have a comma there, or even a full stop, and then say, "Why?" with a question mark. "Then oh why can't I?" with another question mark. So you've got two places where you would naturally pause if you were saying the sentence. And in music, it's very, very similar. Now look at example two. Here, "Birds fly over the rainbow" is the same as before, but this time you've got "Why then?" and then your question mark. So you may want to pause in different places, not even just to take a breath, but for dramatic effect. And I want you to kind of work that out yourself. Now listen out for where I do it in the two versions. And after you've learnt how to play the song, I want you to think about where you're going to breathe and how you're going to make this song your own.
Thank you.
I really hope you enjoyed that lesson, and I really look forward to teaching you in the next lesson. So until then, bye-bye.